Assalamualaikum and welcome to class 8 Islamiyat. I am Sir Zulfiqar Hussain. Our today's topic is declaration of faith, which is known as Shahada. And according to it, we say that I bear witness that there is no God besides Allah, and I bear witness that Muhammad is his servant and the messenger. It is the first pillar of Islam and is called as Tawheed in Arabic terminology as well. And Tawheed is actually to accept by tongue and testify by heart. It means that whatever we believe in Allah Almighty, it should be testified. It should not be only by the tongue. And what we do say that Allah alone is the worthy of worship, that we should not worship to any other being, whether living or non-living. He has infinite powers and authority. Whatever is happening in the world and what will happen in future as well, all is in Allah's power. No one has any kind of association or any kind of equivalence in the power of Allah Almighty. On the basis of all this, we do say that Allah is omnipotent, all-powerful, omniscient, all-knowing, and omnipresent, all-present, boundless. Apart from that, we say that He is the Creator, the Sustainer, and He is the Lawgiver, Owner and the Universe, and the Supreme Authority for the Mankind. That is why Quran says that Thee do we worship and Thine aid we seek. It means that He is the only one who has authority to support us, who has authority to help us, and no other being, whether living or non-living, has any kind of power or authority to support anyone. Allah is invisible. Nobody can see Allah Almighty at all, but yes, we can see Allah Almighty in different kinds of His creations. In other words, we can say that Allah Almighty can be seen in human beings, heavens, earth, ocean, rivers, solar system, and whatsoever happening in our surroundings. Allah Almighty is all alone, and all powers are there with Allah Almighty, and He is going to observe each and everything on His own, and He never gets fatigued. Whatever we study in Ayat al-Kursi, that He is the owner of the whole of the universe, and He alone is going to look after it. That's why Quran says that He is the first, He is the last, He is the manifest, and He is the hidden. Means Allah Almighty was when there was nothing. Allah will be there when everything will be destroyed. And Allah can be seen, and Allah is also unseen. How can we see Allah? I already told you that we can see Allah Almighty in different kinds of His creations. Otherwise, Allah cannot be seen with our natural naked eye. Here you can see the word is polytheism or shirk. This is actually associating partners with Allah in His divine authority. In mean karke, that person do worship something else, like idols made of stone, made of wood, or even the portraits made by the people with own hands. So whenever we bow in front of any other being and do consider that Allah alone does not deserve to be worshipped, and Allah alone is unable to support or help us, that kind of understanding, that kind of belief is known as shirk, and it is the unpardonable sin in Islam. And Quran is very clear that Allah says Allah forgives not that partner should be set up with Him, but He forgives anything else to whom He pleases. Allah Ta'ala will never forgive for the people who do associate partners with Allah Almighty. So people must avoid from shirk and must avoid from associating partners with Allah Almighty at any level. Here we can see that the people who are involved in such kind of belief are known as polytheists, means they are mushrik. And we usually know that we call people of Makkah as mushrikeen in Makkah. This is why, because they did not believe in the divine authority of Allah Almighty. That is why Muslims must avoid from this shirk. There are three types of shirk, polytheism. Number one is shirk fil rububiyyah, which means that shirk in the existence of God. In this situation or in this understanding, people worship multiple gods and they do believe that there are other gods as well besides Allah. Allah alone is not the worthy of worship, and they do also consider that Jesus is the Son of God. The second type of shirk is shirk fil ibadah, shirk in the worship of God. In this understanding of shirk, people do not accept Allah Almighty alone worthy of worship, and therefore they slaughter their animals in the way of gods, and they do not accept that Allah alone is the one and only. They do sacrifice for the animals, they do sacrifice for the non-living objects like idols, like different kinds of portraits and so on. And they also bow in front of other people and go to other people for support and for their worship as well. So people must avoid from this kind of shirk, that is shirk fil ibadah. The third type of shirk is shirk fil asma wa sifat, shirk in the God's attributes. We know that Allah Almighty has so many attributes, we call them sifat, and we usually consider that there are 99 names of Allah Almighty which are considered as His attributes. People do not accept that Allah Almighty alone has the authority, then they say that many other gods are there who has authority and power to create or to give some punishment to the people, or they can give and snatch the knowledge from the people's mind, and they do not practice alone Allah Almighty, but they do worship other gods as well, and they do not accept that Allah Almighty is having all the authorities we usually call as 99 names of Allah Almighty. After shirk fil asma wa sifat, our this topic is ended, and now you can see that there is assignment, and we do consider this is simply a question for you according to the O-level standard. The question says, believe in the oneness of God, Tawheed, is a fundamental aspect of faith. State how Tawheed benefits Muslims in their every life, day life. Theek hai? Now instructions are that read the given material and write an essay length of about 1.5 to 2 pages answer.